Hello everybody, it's Jen. Welcome to day 10 of the Holiday Card Series and a design team project for Trinity Stamps. Today I'm going to be using the Sunny Studio Holiday Chair paper pad, as well as the Greetings of the Season and the Merry Christmas Sentimini stamp sets. I'm bringing in the Merry Christmas word dies as well, and I'm just showing you here that these word dies actually cut out the Merry Christmas in the Sentimini stamp set as well, so you can get lots of use out of that stamp and die. I'm bringing in the Noel die as well, and also the little sentiment strip there that comes in the Merry Christmas. The star of the show is the mug dies from Trinity Stamps. You all loved when I made some projects for the fall using this die set, so I thought I'd bring it back for some holiday cards. I've gone ahead and I've cut out the die using some pattern paper here, and I'm going to show you three examples of how you can decorate the mug cards here to get a different look for them and just to show you how versatile this die actually is. So for this one that I'm working on right now, I'm using the Noel die, and I cut that out of some glitter cardstock just to give a little bit of added glitter and shine to that card. For the one in the middle, I'm using that peppermint or candy cane stripe pattern paper. And I went ahead and cut the Merry Christmas out of some white glitter cardstock as well. And again, I think this just gives a little added interest to the sentiment itself. Then I'm going to work on the left-hand mug here. And I used the shadow die in white cardstock for the Mary and cut the Mary out of some glitter cardstock, the same one that I used for the Noel. With the busy pattern, I wanted to make sure I had those shadow dies underneath just so that you could see the sentiments a little better. So for the Mary card, I'm going to stamp out the sentiment here onto the banner die, and that sentiment says have a cup of, and I'm going to adhere that to the top of the Mary. For the Noel card, I'm also going to stamp out have a cup of cheer, and I'll place that underneath the large Noel sentiment. So these cards are perfect. You can create them for various people on your Christmas list, and you can really change them up depending on the pattern paper that you're using. These could be coffee, they could be hot cocoa or tea. So for one of these, I'm going to actually make this into a gift card holder. Actually two, sorry. And the other one I'm just going to have as a card. So I've gone ahead and I've cut out the full size of the die on some cardstock. So I'm using white cardstock, red cardstock, and then I thought I would throw in some blue cardstock for some fun. It matched the pattern paper perfectly. So I'm just going to add the paper die cut mugs onto the cardstock. These dies make it very simple to create a mug card, and you can also use these with your images, or you can simply add them, you can cut them in half and add them to a card base, and they look great like that as well. So you don't have to use them just as the card die or the mug card die itself. You can add it to a regular sized card. So for this particular card, I'm going to be adding some fun little sprinkles into the top of the mug to make a shaker card. I wanted this card to be all themed in peppermint type Christmas candies. So I'm going to go ahead and add some acetate here. This is actually just some overhead projector sheets that I purchased really inexpensively, and it does the trick for shaker cards. I will leave that listed in the product list below, as well as the other supplies that I use today. So I'm going to be using the peppermint candy sprinkles to add to my little coffee mug here, and you can see them once I turn the mug around, just kind of popping out of the area where the beverage would be on the mug. So added lots of foam tape here, just one layer. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to take off the release paper at the top, and I'm going to add some brown cardstock just to back that. Then I can add some liquid adhesive and go ahead and put this onto the card panel here. So this just adds a little bit of fun. Not sure if those peppermint mints would melt too quickly to see them in an actual cup of coffee or hot cocoa, but I love the added effect it gives for this card. For our card with the pattern paper with the mugs, I'm going to go ahead and just add the brown cardstock right on top, or where it snugly fits into the piece that was cut out. Same for our candy cane striped mug card as well, but I used some white glitter paper for that, just to pick up on the glitter paper I used for the Merry Christmas sentiment. The mug dies do come with this gift card holder, which is great. You can use them for the mug dies, but you can also go ahead and add them into any card you make. And now we can move on to embellishing the cards. So for the peppermint one here, or the candy cane one, sorry, I'm going to add these large peppermint candies and also tinier ones to the front of the card. And I'm just adhering those with some liquid glue, and they've stayed put and I'm not worried about them moving. I'm just going to show you here how you can add the gift cards to the inside, and these make great little gifts. You can tuck them in an envelope, or you could even hang them on a Christmas tree for someone, which I think would be pretty cute. And that little peppermint got away from me there. I didn't adhere it down. So just added some more glue and it is stuck on there now. So here's a look at all three cards. Like I said, two of them I made into gift cards, which are so needed in my house over the holidays. And the other one is just a simple card that I can send to anyone. So here's another holiday video for you. I hope you've enjoyed these mug cards, and I will see you really soon in the next holiday video. Take care, everybody. Thank you so much for watching, and I appreciate all of your comments. Have a great day. Bye.